and talents, their unique personalities and spirits, which God will unite together into one being as they build a life together. We rejoice with them in thankfulness to the Lord for creating this union of hearts built on friendship, respect, and love. Let's pray. Father, we're so grateful. It's just, it's amazing, it's humbling, it's an awesome privilege to be here. Lord, many of us have known Shae and Desiray for maybe all their lives. For me to be able to be here and take part in this is such a privilege. And Father, I pray that you'll just pour out your Spirit upon them, pour out your blessing upon them. May their lives be centered around the person of Jesus Christ, and may the totality of their marriage and all the time that you give them together bring you honor and glory and great blessing to their lives. And we ask you this in Jesus' name. Amen. You can be seated. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Your mother and I.
Shae and Desiray have asked me to read some scriptures here, and it's Ecclesiastes chapter 4, beginning in verse 9. It says, two are better than one, because they have good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow, but woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, they have heat, but how can one be warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him, and a threefold cord is not quickly broken. I want to focus a minute on the threefold cord. What makes this union so special today? Of course, we love Shae and we love Desiray, and most of you are here for that reason. But what makes it a threefold cord is God, and the fact that each one of them have received the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. Desiray, when she was young, received Christ as her Savior. I remember when she was in the second grade, she already knew the Lord as her Savior. She'd been scripturally baptized. She was a serious little church member at Faith Baptist Church. And I decided that the Lord wanted to kind of challenge the church to see if we could all read through the Bible in 1 year. And she came to me and said, Pastor, do you think it'd be okay if I got one of those sheets, one of those calendars that help you know what to read every day? I think I might be able to do it. And I said, sure, that's great. That's awesome. And she's the youngest person I know of that ever read through the Bible all the way in 1 year. She did it. And then, of course, watching you graduate and just all the things that we've got to watch. And then Shae coming into the picture here not too long ago, a few years ago, and maybe a little longer, but it's been a great blessing for me this last year to be able to take a day a week, not a day, but a few hours a week with Shae and just spend time with him in the Word of God. And finally, we got to the part where we were getting ready for marriage and doing the marriage counseling. And that's been a real blessing. And Shae, I love you. Desiray, I love you. And excited about you two getting married. What makes this marriage so special and unique is Jesus Christ. If you're here this evening, afternoon, late afternoon, and you don't know Christ as your Savior, just real quickly, they want you to know that you can. And if their coming together would somehow bring you together with Jesus Christ, that'd be about the greatest thing they could imagine happening. And so quickly, just to understand that we're all sinners, we're all in need of a Savior. But God did something about that. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And God the Father sent God the Son to live a perfect and sinless life. And then Jesus qualified as God and also as perfect man to die for our sins, because he had no sin of his own. He died for our sins, he was buried, and he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. And he conquered death and hell and the grave. And if you would respond to him, because God promised that sometime in your life he would begin to move in your heart. He'd make himself known to you. If you'd receive Jesus Christ as your Savior, he'll forgive your sins, save your soul, give you an abundant life, a wonderful life, and one day a home eternal in heaven. And if you have any more questions about this, we would love to talk with you about it. But we're going to keep going at this point. I think I might have felt a little teeny drop. Just a small one. So, Shae, will you have Desiray to be your wife, to live together as friend and mate? Will you love her as a person, respect her as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep her beside you as long as you both shall live? Desiray, will you have Shae to be your husband, to live together as friend and mate? Will you love him as a person, respect him as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep him beside you as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Amen. Shae, please repeat after me. I love you, Desiray.
I love you, Desiray.
As I love no other.
As I love no other.
All that I am,
I
share with you. I take you to be my wife, through health and sickness, through plenty and want, through joy and sorrow, now and forever. Desiray, please repeat after me. I love you, Shae.
I love you, Shae.
As I love no other.
As I love no other.
All that I am,
I share with you.
I take you to be my husband, through health and sickness, through plenty and want,
through joy and sorrow,
now and forever.
Now.
Amen. The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It's an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in an endless love. And now, as a token of your love and your deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, you, Shae, may place a ring on the finger of your bride. Shae, repeat after me. Desiray,
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love
and faithfulness to you.
By the same token, Desiray, you may place a ring on the finger of your groom. And please repeat after me. Shae,
I
give you this ring
as
a symbol of my love
and faithfulness to you.
Amen. Maybe some of you have seen at a wedding, maybe not, the sand ceremony. At this time, I'll just tell you a little bit about it while they're getting ready. The most beautiful example of a partnership is marriage. You have committed here today to share the rest of your lives together. Today, this relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand into one, representing you, Desiray, all that you were and all that you are and all that you will ever be. And the other representing you, Shae, all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you will ever be. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage be united as one for all of your days.
I've been a walking heartache, I've made a mess of me. The person that I've been lately ain't who I wanna be. But just stay here right beside me, watch as the storm blows through. God gave me you for the days of doubt. For when I think I've lost my way, there are no words here left to say it's true. God gave me you. Yeah. There's more here than what we're seeing. A divine conspiracy that you, an angel lovely, could somehow fall for me. But you'll always be love's gray martyr, and I'll be the flattered fool, and I need you. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. For when I think I've lost my way, there are no words here left to say. It's true. God gave me you. On my own, I'm only half of what I could be. I can't do without you. We are stitched together, and what love has tethered, I pray we never undo. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. For when I think I've lost my way, there are no words here left to say. It's true. God gave me you. Gave me you. He gave me you.
Desiray and Shae, through their words today, have joined together in holy wedlock. Because they have exchanged their vows before God and these witnesses, have pledged their commitment each to the other, and have declared the same by the joining of hands and exchanging rings, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife. Those that God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. You may now kiss the bride. Good job. It is my distinct honor and privilege to introduce to you for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Shae Young. Good job. We'll wait for you.